Hello everyone. So now let us move to the common doubt which almost every student is suffering from, that after my graduation which stream should I follow. So basically selection of stream depends on your own interest, what you are focused in, what is your interest. But if most of the students try and follow the particular stream which is in demand, you should get a clear idea about which stream is in demand and why is it so. Like in India, most of the institutions have masters in pharm chem, which you also call as med chem. Then comes pharmaceutics, pharm analysis, pharmacology. Pharmacognosy, you can call it as natural products as well. Regulatory affairs. So basically these are the common streams which are available at almost all the post-graduation colleges. In PharmChem, what we basically do is we design a new drug that involves total chemistry, new synthesis and all. Once the new drug is ready, it goes to the pharmaceutics department to be converted into a formulation. So it is basically drug design over here, and here it is the development of a particular formulation. In pharm analysis, they check the particular desired concentration of drug is being achieved or not, what are the components and all. In pharmacology, we basically try and identify a target where the drug is to be targeted. When it comes to pharmacognosy, you move to natural products and all to find out new drugs for the treatment of diseases. Then comes our regulatory affairs, which basically deals with patent application and all. So if you ask me what is in more demand, I'll say as far as my experience goes and what I had a talk with everyone around, it is pharmaceutics which is more in demand. The reason for pharmaceutics being more in demand and why industry is focusing more on it is mostly the dosage form design is for the existing drugs. Since India doesn't have much of new drugs coming into the market, we are basically converting the same drugs into different formulations and trying to improve the efficacy. While if you go to PharmChem, it basically involves synthesis of new drugs. So when we come up with a new structure, it is just the base, then making it into a formulation analysis, then the regulatory part of it. So it involves a lot of investment, which Indian companies are not able to do. And since it's drug designing, it's not only people from pharmacy who can work in this stream, also MSc people can work in this. So they are our competitors. When you go to pharm analysis, same is the case. People from MSc background can also work in analytical section. So basically pharmaceutics is such a field where only pharma people can work in, because we are the only one who have the idea about the formulation. So we don't have competitors from other stream in this department, and most of the countries are also running pharmaceutics as a evergreen field, so it is any day preferable. Many countries have a lot of demand for pharmacology as well, not that greatly developed in India. Pharmacology is more of focus because you try and identify the target site, and then comes your PharmChem part, how to target, how to design a drug to reach that target. It's basically these two streams which are in more demand. And you, if you ask an evergreen stream, or let it be India or any country, then it is pharmaceutics. Based on your interest, you should select a particular field, not being driven by pharmaceutics just because it is in demand. But if it's not of your interest, it's of no use. Going to pharmacognosy, basically the herbal drugs, converting and extracting those drugs into a particular formulation. And then comes our regulatory affairs, the patent application in different countries, how to make a particular drug being applicable in different countries, because different countries have different laws, so it's totally paperwork, no lab work involved in this case. So what I'll suggest is basically first think what is your interest, target that, the scope will find its way. If you are efficient enough, and if it's your field of interest, you will be the best. Thank you.